Hi, welcome to Xi'an. It's really cold here. I think it's 11 degrees according to the weather forecast. I just arrived yesterday from North Korea and happy to be back in China, but I'm having problems with the VPN, so I cannot use YouTube. It's not working these days. So I'm thinking going to the Terracotta Army today, maybe. Anyway, this is the view from my balcony. I rented a little room here. So the question is if I go today or tomorrow. Let's see. There's a mall nearby. And this is my wonderful little apartment. So I'm back in China, starting my trip to Xi'an. And this is the train station. Lots of people because the autumn festival just ended. And I'm gonna catch my train, which is already not ready for boarding yet. This one to Xi'an. Too many people. And not even free seats. You have to take the bread and make it small by yourself. So this is the dish, it's still hot. It's a beef, yeah. Yeah, and it's called Paomo. We eat it with the garlic, sweet garlic. And it's very delicious. Oh my God, it's so cold. So there's the city wall. But I don't know how to get there. So I found the entrance, but I'm really hungry. I mean, it's 4 p.m. I haven't eaten anything today. So I gotta get some food first. So, I just finished my dinner, my only meal today, which was very delicious hot pot. And only for 29 yuan, which is less than 4 US dollar, all you can eat, delicious food, lots of vegetables, I had lots of spinach, but didn't have too much peanuts as well. And even drinks were included, I even had cola, but I just had water. Tried to stick to my diet, but I ate still too much peanuts, I think it was like 2000 calories. But yeah, it should be my only meal per day. Starting intermittent fasting again after eating way too much food in North Korea. Probably gained a kilo or two. So now I have to lose it again. But no time for the gym, but I'm going to take a walk. I'm going to the city wall now. Weather is bad, but it's not raining. So I'm at the city wall now. And here it is. Very impressive entrance. I don't know how the buses got in here. These are open before. Yeah, let's see how far we can walk. I read on the internet that it's about 4 to 5 hours for a round trip around the city. I'm not sure if I can make it today, especially it's late. So, and up we are on the top. Having a nice view over the city. I hope it won't rain. Apparently you can take a car or they even have bikes you can rent here. but I'm gonna walk. So, I finished one part already, which is 1/8. Took me a bit more than a half hour, but there's still much more to see. It's a very nice place here. It's getting dark and the wall is getting empty. I hope it's gonna be the end soon. I'm trying to make half the way and it takes me, I don't know, I think I'm already 1 hour walking at least. Yeah, so I guess 90 minutes for half the way. You can make it in 3 hours if you walk fast. Over there is the end, still a bit to walk. So that seems to be the center, but why are there no stairs down? It's still a bit further. To walk back here to get to the subway, I guess. Oh, I need to pee. Oh, finally made it. Oh, it was exhausting, but it was worth it. So now heading back home, taking a rest, and tomorrow seeing the Terracotta Army. It's nice with the light, almost like Christmas. To the metro. I chose the best day to see the Terracotta Army. Raining heavily, but I don't want to waste time. The weather forecast said it's gonna rain every day from today, like the next week. So I don't want to waste some time. It's also too cold here. I want to leave as soon as possible to see the Terracotta Army, and then on Thursday go to Shanghai. So unfortunately, I don't have an umbrella. And I don't want to buy one because I don't want to carry it. Usually I don't go out when it's raining, basically, so I don't need an umbrella. I mean, I traveled for 1 year and then almost never needed an umbrella, but I don't want to waste time, so I just go out in the rain and hope to survive somehow. Hope my bus is coming soon, and I could change once, and then I'm going to be in a Terracotta Army in 2 hours from here. Yeah, not so close. Bus, it costs 30 cents. Finally arrived at the Terracotta Army. It's really one of the worst days to go because it is so freezing and rainy. But I just don't want to spend much more time here in Xi'an. There's not much to do and to see besides good food. And the next few days they're all raining. The forecast is raining every day and it's cold, like it won't get better. It's actually 60 degrees today. It's really, really cold. I didn't bring a jacket because I just don't want to travel in cold places. So I have a sweater and a t-shirt and I think it's fine. I mean, I saw this guy in short pants. Anyway, right now we're here in Terracotta. I haven't taken a look yet. I just wanted to get the experience on tape. So I think I can feel the first one myself. Well, let's see here the soldiers. And there are just many of them. That's the fascinating thing, that there are just so many. Let's see, they're detailed. Everyone is their own personality. And yeah, there was no student discount, very expensive. I paid 20 euro, more than 20 US dollar for this. I really hope it's worth it, you know. I hope that's not the main thing. I hope there's more to see than just this place. There's a horse. And many, many soldiers. And many, many people too. I'm wondering if there are more soldiers or more people. I think more people. Esmo Terracotta Experience. It's expensive, it's bad weather, and it's really crowded here. But yeah, it's still not that bad. Still very fascinating. Especially the amount. Here are some of the restoration works. They were actually back glued together in one piece. Must have been a lot of work to reassemble the soldiers. And there are so many of them, that's why it is so fascinating. But besides of this, it's overpriced. Still, too many people come, so yeah. Here you can see the stages of the restoration progress. First like this, then like this, and then like this. Reassembling them. So then we come back in 50 years and there are gonna be 100 more of them. So last glance. And that's it. The whole experience just takes 50 minutes and we're done. Here is another area which just recently has been discovered, 40 years ago, so you don't see much. Lots of work to do. This is a terracotta photo session. Souvenirs. Nothing of interest. Another unrestored site. This is the second one. Oh, and they also have a photo session. Oh, but this looks a bit better. They already restored some soldiers. And here we also can take photos. Maybe they are fake. I'm not sure. They look too good to be real. Well, lots of people had a good time here. It's a museum. So that's it. think I'm finished here. It's been about 90 minutes to see everything, including the museum. Yeah, it was alright. But not like super interesting. It's not like as good as the Taj Mahal. But it was still, of course, worth coming if you're near to Xi'an. Yeah. And now going back to Xi'an, eating something. I haven't eaten and it's 12. Yesterday I only had one meal, so it's yeah, good diet after eating too much in North Korea. Excuse me, which bus?
The end of the visit.
Ah, okay. Thank you very much. Okay. Xixini. These are the famous Biang Biang noodles. Look delicious. I guess they are. I mean, I'm not a food expert. I will probably like it. Whatever it is. So, back in Xi'an, now at the train station, buying tickets to Shanghai. Yeah, I'm trying a Chinese burger now, raw Maggio. It's very delicious, but it's very fat, so it's not healthy. So I dropped my jeans. So this is called the red bean milk tea. And they actually put it on those lines. But actually, line is blocked here in China. Like Facebook. So. It's just horrible weather today in Xi'an. And probably it's the only video I'm gonna take today. Because it's really cold, really rainy. And it's raining non-stop. I don't even have a heater at home. I'm gonna use the hairdryer sometimes to warm up. So I'm a food court today, because the weather is so bad in the mall.
Chaos in the market.
So many people are anywhere in China. So in the market you can buy all kinds of stuff. But people are too much. We will not make it. Cars will never move. It's kind of like organization as an embassy. And this is food. As you maybe know, I'm always on diet, but today I decided to follow the food ranger's advice, because Xi'an is very famous for their foods. So I'm here in the Muslim quarter now and trying the famous dumpling. Food is served, but it looks very, very spicy. I hope I can eat it. So it is very delicious, a bit spicy, but not as spicy as it looks, but also not that crazy delicious. It's good, but not like a super thing. Next up, dumplings again, this time steamed. Very good. I would say it's even better than the previous restaurant. So highly recommended this Jiaozi. The next try. This is like, I don't know what it is. Meat with rice and fat. I don't know if I will like it. Oh, that was disgusting. It was so disgusting. I don't know why the food ranger recommends this stuff. It was like full of fat, you know? Maybe she gave me a bad portion. It wasn't even cheap, like €2, €2. More than $2 actually. And yeah, really not delicious, really fatty. I only ate, yeah, still one third, I guess. But I don't feel good afterwards. I feel like street food. But one more stop, and then I'm gonna have a snack. So, last stop, Baozi. It's alright, but again, it's, I don't know, it's not so delicious, and there were no vegetables involved. today. No vegetables. I tried five dishes and no vegetables involved. So I will never listen to the food ranger again. I mean, he always shows up on the search results, and today is the first time I tried his recommendations. But I must say I'm very disappointed. There was only one delicious dish, and even one was delicious. They're all not healthy. There were no vegetables involved, and the flavor was not overwhelming. It was one dish was even disgusting, the previous one. So anyway, I'm good, and I'm going back home. I'm going to Shanghai today. So after public bicycles become more and more popular all over the world, the newest invention is the dockless public bicycle, which looks like this. And they're all around. Look, there are other ones, there are yellow ones, different companies. I think there are two companies here in Xi'an. So all you need is to download this app. You make an Alipay account. And you scan this QR code on the bicycle. Now on the map, they also show you like where is the closest bike. So you just click on unlock. And it automatically finds the bike. Yeah, and it goes unlocking. See, it's unlocked, and now I can ride, and it only costs 15 US cents for 30 minutes. It's really cheap. The only thing is you have to put a $40 deposit in your account, but you get it back if you unregister. So when I leave China, I will get the money back, and yeah. But you also get $3 for free, yeah, in the bike for money. And then you just start riding, yeah, and enjoy the city. Today is good weather, luckily. And as you can see, those bikes are everywhere. I think this yellow bike is a bit more common than the orange bike, which I have. Mine is called Mobike, this is called Ofo. Yeah, but it doesn't matter. One bike is enough, and there are plenty everywhere in the city. So the good thing is, you can basically park everywhere, which is right in front of my door. But when you finish, you just put this. So the only thing I would complain is they have no gears. This is just a bell, and this thing is kind of poisonous. So the handles, they give me like itchy hands. I think they're like poisonous because they use the cheap silicone or like plastic, probably soft plastics, which are very, very harmful. I heard 1 hour holding the thing is equal to smoking 100 cigarettes. I don't know if it's that serious, but certainly not good. So this is the only thing I would complain, and there are no gears. But besides, it's good because you can park everywhere. It's better than the docking stations, and I think the handles in Taiwan are also not that good. Yeah, you also get itchy hands after a while. Yeah, it's really annoying. You need to wear gloves to avoid this in summer. Yeah.